This video is going to lead you to become confident in solving the most important problem using iteration method. So here is the process for the iteration method. Let us suppose that a is the root of the function f of x is equal to 0, which is equivalent to x is equal to phi of x. We have to take x in terms of phi of x. I be any interval containing the point x is equal to a. So this root point should contain in the interval I. And the third condition here is modulus of phi dash of x. Here is phi of x, and if you make a derivative, that value should be less than 1. Then we have to use this iteration method. First of all, let a be the root of the given equation f of x is equal to 0. So which it is equivalent to x is equal to phi of x. So here I be any interval containing this point x is equal to a. Within the interval the root should lie, and the third condition here is the derivative, modulus of the derivative value should be less than 1, so that we can use this iteration method. And here is the problem related to this, and this is most important problem. So find out the root of the given equation. So first of all, we have to find the root of the given equation, that is x cubed plus x squared minus 1 is equal to 0. First of all, I am treating this as f of x. So f of x is equal to, this is x cubed plus x squared minus 1. So initially, if I put x is equal to 0 here, so if I put x is equal to 0, then f of 0 value will be 0 plus 0 minus 1, so which is less than 0. So if I keep x is equal to 1 in place of x, if I keep x is equal to 1, so this will be f of 1. So this is 1 plus 1 minus 1. So if I cancel this one, so the value is 1 and this is greater than 0. So I got less than for one time and greater than for another time. So if I get different roots, so we have to stop and we have to assume that the root lies between. The root lies between x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1. So we have to confirm that the root lies between x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1. For that we have to consider x naught. X naught is equal to, this is this value, that is 0 plus 1 by 2. So our x naught value will be 1 by 2. So x naught value is equal to 0.5. So remember this one, we got x naught value as 0.5. So what is the question here? It was given that x cubed plus x square minus 1 is equal to 0. So there are three cases here, so in which we have to write in terms of phi of x. So there are three cases here, that is x square minus 1 is equal to 0. So see, if you observe this one properly, then so in this we can take that x cube is equal to 1 minus x square, isn't it? So later, what is our x? This is 1 minus x square whole to the power of 1 by 3 in this case. So in this case, so if you take this x square in terms of x square, so x square will be 1 minus x cube, and x value will be, this is 1 minus x cube power half. And here, if I take x common from these two, so x square common from these two, this will be x plus 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, and x square into x plus 1 is equal to 1, and x square is equal to 1 by x plus 1, and x value will be 1 by root over, this is x plus 1. So in all these cases, so we have to consider this as phi of x. X is equal to phi of x. The second step I said that. So x is equal to phi of x is 1 minus x square power 1 by 3. Here also. So phi of x is equal to 1 minus x cube power, this is half. Here phi of x is equal to, this value will be x plus 1 power minus half. So again we have to make a derivative of this. So in order to make a derivative of this, the process is very easy. F dash of x is equal to, this is n into x power, this is n minus 1. So this is n minus 1, and again for x square, this is 2x. So phi dash of x will be, so our phi dash of x value will be, this is minus 2x. And this one is 2 times of, so this is minus 2 by 3. So this is 1 minus x square, this is 2 by 3. in this case. So if you see this one, so if I make a derivative, then phi dash of x is equal to, see, this is n into 1 minus x cube whole to the power of n minus 1, and for again minus x cube, this will be minus 3x square. Therefore phi dash of x value will be, so this is minus 3x square by 2 times of 1 minus x cube power half. So if it comes down, it will be plus half. And again, if you see this one, so if I make a derivative, that is phi dash of x, phi dash of x is equal to n into, this is x power n minus 1, and for x it is 1, and x it is 1. So phi dash of x value is equal to, this is minus half, and this value will be 1 by 1 plus x power, this is 3 by 2. So 3 by 2. Again, in each and every case, so we have to substitute the value here. So what is our value here? Our x naught value is nothing but, x naught value is nothing but 0.5. In each and every case, if I put x is equal to 0.5, if I keep x is equal to, so here x naught value is 0.5. That is 0.5 wherever you find. So after putting and substituting, so here it is minus value, here it is minus value, and here it is a minus value. So we want modulus of phi of x. So if I keep in x 0.5, this will be minus 2 times of, this is 0.5 by 2 times of, this is 1 minus 0.5 whole square per 2 by 3. And here, if you observe this one, if I keep here in this, that is phi dash of x value will be minus 3. This is 0.5 whole square by 2 times of 1 minus 0.5 whole cube power half. And here, if I keep 0.5, so this value will be phi dash of x is equal to, this is minus 1 by 2 times of 1 plus 0.5 power 3 by 2. And here, if in each and everything, in each and every case, we have to take a positive value. So if I take a positive value, even though the value is negative, if it comes from modulus, the value here is 0.4038, and here the value is 0.4008, and here the value is modulus of phi of x value. The modulus of phi of x value is 0.272. If you compare this one, so if you compare this one, modulus of phi dash of x, so which value is minimum value? So the minimum value we have to consider, and we have to consider that one, 0.4 0.4 0.2. so this value is a minimum value, so we have to consider phi of x as this one. So we have to consider this value, phi of x is equal to, so this whole thing you no need to do, this just I'm explaining. And here our phi of x value is nothing but, if you can see this phi of x value, we got as phi of x value is nothing but 1 by root over, this is x plus 1. So we have to consider this form. So there are three cases, that is case 1, case 2 and case 3. Whichever phi dash of x, modulus of phi dash of x is minimum, that value we have to consider. So here we have to frame that x n plus 1. So x of n plus 1 is equal to 1 by root over xn plus 1. So in this, if I put n is equal to 0, so if I keep n is equal to 0, so this value will be, if I keep n is equal to 0, this value will be x1 is equal to root over, this is x0 plus 1. So we know that x0 is nothing but 0.5. So just now I have calculated here, that is 0.5. So this value will be 0.5 plus 1. So the root value I'm showing, so this is 0.5 plus 1, this is a square root, and again inverse. So this value is, so this value is nothing but 0.8164, so which is equal to 0.8164 is the answer. So again, if I keep n is equal to, see here, if I keep n is equal to 1, this time I'll get x2 value. So x2 value is nothing but root over, this is x1 plus 1. So what is our x1 value? This is our x1. So the latest value here, that is 0.8164 plus 1 value, is nothing but, so again I have to do this, that is 1 plus 0.8164 square root, and again inverse. The value here is 0 point. So here this is 0.74198. And if I keep n is equal to, so here if I keep n is equal to 2, then x3 value this time will be 1 by root over, this is x2 plus 1. So which is equal to, what is our x2 value? So x2 value will be 0.74198 plus 1. So which is equal to, so this is 1.74198 square root, and again inverse, the value is 0.75766. and again if I keep n is equal to 3, so if again I keep n is equal to 3, this is x4, which is equal to, this is x3 plus 1, so this value is nothing but this is 0.75766 plus 1, so which we can write as 1.75766. That is a square root, and again inverse, sorry. So this is 1.75766. We want square root first of all. So see here, this is 1.075766 value, and for this we have to find the square root, and again we have to find the inverse, and this is 0.754279. and again if I keep n is equal to, so if I keep n is equal to 4, then x power 5 value will be 1 by root over x power 4 plus 1, so which is equal to 1 by root over, this is 0.754279 plus 1, so this value will be, see here, this is 1 plus 0.7542, this is 71 square root, and again inverse, this value is 0.7, this is 5500, and the next if I keep n is equal to 5, then the x6 value will be, this is x power 5 plus 1, so which is equal to 1 by root over, this is 0.755 plus 1, and this value will be, this is, see here, 1 plus 0.755, again square root, and again inverse, and this value is 0.7548. and again if I keep n is equal to 6, then x power 7 value will be root over, this is x power 6 plus 1, so which is equal to, this is root over 0.7548 plus 1, so which you can see here, that is 1 plus 0.7548, this is a square root, and again inverse. So the value here is 0.7548. So again we got a repeated answers here. So we have to conclude that the real root of the given equation. Therefore, the real root of the given equation is x is equal to 0.7548. And this is how we have to choose, and this is how we have to solve, and this is the process, and if you follow, this will be very easy. So this is the iteration method. First of all, we have to take it as f of x, and initially we have to give all the values. If it's negative and positive, we have to stop, and we have to conclude that the root lies between 0 and 1. So x naught is the average of these two. So 0 plus 1 by 2 x naught. So which value we have to consider as phi of x? So in this equation, there are three cases in which we have to take in terms of phi of x. So there are three cases here. This is case 1. So this is case 1, and this is case 2, and this is case 3. So anyway, after choosing and after substituting all the values, I got this value as a minimum value, and I'm considering phi of x is equal to x plus 1 by root over x plus 1. So after getting phi of x, so we have to transform this as x of n plus 1 is equal to 1 by root over x n plus 1. We have to keep giving all the values, n values, so that here x1 value, this is x2 value, x3 value. So we got two repeated answers, and therefore we have to conclude that the real root of the given equation is x is equal to 0.7542. I hope that you're confident enough in solving this problem. If you practice well, definitely you can solve. And please have a look at my next video too. I'll be posting all the topics from this. Thank you so much.